Hi, I'm Matt, Product Manager at Volterra, and this is Nova, our digital manufacturing platform for additive or printed electronics. I've already taken you through the anatomy of Nova, so if you missed that, definitely start there. In this video, I'm going to be taking you through calibrating the print settings for a new material with Nova's semi-automated calibration routine. Let's go! The calibrate workflow is a semi-automated procedure that allows you to quickly and easily figure out the settings for a new ink without a material science PhD. Today, we're going to be calibrating a new ink, the RD0112A silver-based conductive ink from ACI out in California. We'll be using this ink in our dispense video to print a flexible electronic circuit, so make sure to check that out. At the end of this walkthrough, we'll have the print settings for our new ink dialed in and ready for printing. Let's dive in. To access Nova, we start by connecting to the software through Nova's browser-based web app. Each device has a unique assigned name. This one is called Boron, but you can find yours on the device sticker on the side of the machine. Thanks to Nova's built-in Wi-Fi connectivity, I could be in a completely different room at this point, and I'd be able to help guide the calibration. Once we access Nova's software, we land on the homepage. On the right, we have the calibrate workflow. Next up is probing the calibration plate to create a height map of the surface. For this, we're going to need the smart probe. As you can see, the stylus is touching down at specific points to generate the height map. Before we get our print settings, we need to tell Nova exactly how we want this material to print. We do that in the target quality step. Here, we select our nozzle diameter, tell Nova our target trace width, and set a print height. I'll be using a 150 micrometer nozzle and shooting for a 200 micron trace width at 60 micron height. Let's put on the dispenser. As soon as we mount the dispenser, it begins to heat up to our target temperature of 40 degrees Celsius. With conductive inks, even slight temperature changes in the room can cause large changes in viscosity. The smart dispenser's built-in heater makes sure everything is consistent. Next, the estimate pressure step will give us a baseline dispense pressure for this new material. Because each ink has different properties, it likely has a different starting point. Nova is going to start incrementing the pressure until we see a little bit of ink coming out of the nozzle. At that point, we just hit stop, and that will be our initial dispensing pressure estimate. With the pressure estimated, we can move on to the calibrate step. In calibration, Nova will automatically generate some baseline print settings, print a test pattern on the calibration plate, and take a photo for us to inspect. All we do then is tell Nova how to improve it, and Nova will try again until we get print settings we're happy with. This is where the Wi-Fi connectivity together with the camera system really shines. I could be in a completely different room at this point, and I'd be able to help guide the calibration. Now that you've completed the print, let's have a look at what it looks like. As we can see here, some of these lines are just a little bit thin, so I'll tell Nova to increase the width a little bit. Then I'll hit improve to generate new settings. Just hit print again, and after a couple of prints, you should have your print settings dialed in. As you can see, after 5 prints, we've got the settings exactly where we want them to be. The lines are all consistent, there are no gaps in any of the traces, and the pads are filled in. This is an excellent print. Let's click Use. At this point, we've calibrated our material, and we're just going to hit Finish. What I usually do now is I home the system, and then I pop out the plate to have a quick look. Honestly, it looks even better in person. To clean off your calibration plate, just grab a cloth and some IPA and give it a wipe, so your calibration plate is ready for next time. And we're done. Now that we've calibrated this ink's print settings, we can use these anytime we want to dispense a pattern with this material. If you want to see Nova printing a flexible Arduino circuit with this material, check out our other video focusing on dispensing with Nova.